Today I will show you how to perform the rear bevel gear oil change, how to check if the shaft is still in good condition and how to lubricate it properly. If you only want to do the oil change, you will need a Torx 45, a 6mm Allen key and something like a veterinary syringe. Port numbers and torque specifications are listed in the video description. For the shaft check, a Torx 30, 40 and 50 are additionally required. The filler plug can be accessed in two ways without removing the splash guard, either through the arms or from behind. To open the plug, the 6mm Allen key must be used. The drain plug opens with a Torx 45. Here I'm checking for chunks in the oil. None were found. Very good. The drain plug is magnetic. Using a flathead screwdriver, I remove the magnetic residue from the hole. Dark goo in this plug is normal, but metal bits are not. Clean it out, then replace the crush washer for the filler plug and the O-ring for the drain plug. The drain plug is torqued to 20 Newton meters. If you are here only for the oil change, skip to 4 minutes and 47 seconds. To access the shaft, the wheel tire assembly, splash guard, brake caliper, wheel speed sensor and the rear screw of the paralever link must be removed. First, the splash guard must be removed by using Torx 30. The wheel is secured by 5 Torx 50 screws. Then the wheel speed sensor cable is unclipped and both T40 brake caliper screws are removed. The brake caliper can be suspended with a zip tie from the pannier rack. The wheel speed sensor is a Torx 30 and is best stored in a plastic bag to prevent dirt from sticking to it. When opening the paralever link screw, the entire bevel gear assembly can fold down, so it needs to be supported with something like an oil bottle. The rubber gaiter is connected to the shaft tube with 4 tabs, as depicted in the BMW manual. Now I'm checking for wear in the U-joint. If it locks slightly, mainly in the center position, the shaft is bad. After cleaning out all the old grease, new grease must be applied to the spline and yoke. If you buy it from the dealer, you receive this tube. For the rubber gaiter, BMW recommends a very expensive product, but I have no problems using this alternative. According to the manual, the paraleveling screw must be replaced because it's micro-encapsulated with a high-strength locking agent. When folding up the bevel gear assembly, make sure the yoke is facing downward. By turning the brake disc back and forth, the spline eventually engages with the yoke and the rubber gaiter can be clipped into the shaft tube. Then the paraleveling screw is inserted. The Torx 50 screw is torqued to 56 Newton meters. The brake caliper screws must also be replaced due to the locking agent. The wheel speed sensor is torqued with a Torx 30 to 8 Newton meters. Both Torx 40 brake caliper screws are torqued to 28 Newton meters. The bevel gears are filled with 180 milliliters of BMW Hypoid Axle Oil G3 and the 6mm Allen fill plug is torqued to 25 Nm. With this step, the oil change is done. Then the wheel is loosely mounted to the bike and torqued when back on the ground. The Torx 30 splash guard screws are torqued to 8 Nm. The T50 wheel screws are torqued to 60 Nm.